creating an emotional range with him. And so I just want you to notice that we're talking about emotions right now, this whole thing. And a lot of women come to us and they're like, oh, do men even have emotions? We all have emotions. We all decide everything that we're doing based on emotions, and then we backwards rationalize it with our intellect. So absolutely, everybody does things with emotions. Otherwise, everybody would be, all men would be really thin, they'd make lots of money, and they would have great relationships if they didn't do everything based on emotions. But we all do stupid stuff, we all do great stuff, and we do that based on our emotions. And that's why we talk so much about emotions, because when he feels those emotions for you, when that goes away, that's when he'll miss you. And so you want to create an emotional range for him. Being happy isn't the only emotion that men want to experience. And men typically don't experience as much emotion as women do. And so whenever you can connect with him and connect him with emotion, that will help him experience more emotion for himself, and it'll connect him to you in a deeper level. So think of this like a good movie, right? There's bad movies, there's mediocre movies, and there's good movies. Bad movies are movies that suck, they're boring, they're not very funny, and you never want to see them again, right? And a mediocre movie is a movie that's kind of like one-dimensional. It's fun, but it's like, yeah, you know, who really cares that much about the movie? I mean, it was good. It was cool to watch one time, but do I ever want to see it again? Am I ever going to think about it again? Probably not. Maybe if somebody brings it up in a conversation, I'll be like, oh yeah, I saw that movie that one time. But that's not what you want. You want a good movie, right? A good movie is a movie that pulls on your heartstrings. It makes you laugh. It makes you get scared. It makes you cry. It makes you feel anticipation. And you go back and you watch it over and over and over again. You can't get enough of it because you love seeing it. And when you leave, you're like, man, that was such a good movie. Like, what an awesome movie I just watched. Have you ever seen such an amazing movie? Oh, that one point where such and such did whatever, right? And you talk about all these things because it was such a great movie. And now you don't have to become an actress or something like that. However, the point is still there, right? Like, the more emotion that you experience, the more things that happen, the more dimensions there are to what happens with you and him, the more emotionally engaged he'll be, the more he'll feel like he misses you and he wants you back and he wants to see you again and he wants to be with you again. And so the fastest way to elicit these types of emotions is to ask questions. And the way that you do that, and sometimes what you'll have to do, and this takes a little bit of courage on your part, is to come out and talk about things yourself, right? Where if you want a structure to this, what you'd end up doing is you'd say something like, you know, one thing that really kind of scares me is... And then you talk about something that really scares you. For instance, let's say you're really scared of spiders and you're like, oh man, you know, one thing that really scares me is spiders. And you know, I feel like I'm really confident in a lot of other areas of my life and it's fun to go out and do things and I'm adventurous. But as soon as I see a spider, it's like I curl up into a ball and I start crying and I like get really scared and I like freak out and I just... You know, like, it's like I can't do anything anymore when I see these spiders, right? And one, doing something like that will make him feel like he wants to, like, protect you and do all those things because it's kind of like this girly, like, emotional thing that you're doing. And then when you're done with that, you can ask him what he's afraid of, right? Which elicits even more emotion. So the first one's eliciting kind of this masculine primal drive in him. And then asking him about what he's kind of scared of will allow him to think of things that he's actually scared of and feel like get a little bit of a glimpse or a little bit of a taste of that. And if you want to take it even further, ask him about why or what happened or have you ever experienced that before? So let's say that he's scared of clowns or something. And he's like, yeah, you know, when I was a kid, and you ask him like, why? Or like, is there something that happened? And he's like, oh, you know, when I was a kid I went to the circus and there's these clowns all around and I was just really scared. And then my mom like showed up one day in my room and she's like, boo. And she like came out with this clown mask on and I was scared out of my mind. This is the adventures and horrible parents stories right here. But, you know, so for instance, let's say that something like that happened to him. And then all of a sudden it's like, he's experiencing all these things again. He's feeling it and he's talking about it and he's getting these emotions coming up. And so when he's around you then, he's associating all kinds of different emotions around you. And as long as you're doing the other things that we talked about before this, where you're connecting with them, you're making him feel really good most of the time, and you're connecting with them on a deep level, then what's going to end up happening is that it's going to be like this little blip of kind of this other emotion, and it's going to create this more connectivity to you than just being kind of this one-dimensional kind of thing where you're connecting with them. You're just happy. It's superficial. And it's like, oh, is this really anything? Does any of this mean anything? Who really cares? And instead, you're creating an emotion. So other things like, you know, what things have ever made him cry before? What things have made him laugh? Like what does he love? You know, like all these different things. Like just ask him questions about different types of emotions. Talk about different types of emotions that you've had. Tell stories about it, which is the second best way to do this, is through storytelling, which I gave an example a little bit earlier, which is kind of the spider story. Although that's a really small story, you can get into telling even longer stories about actual things that happen, or maybe there's a specific instance where there's a spider and it scared you and freaked you out. Well, that's another great way to have him elicit these emotions, because he's going through kind of this experience with you, and so he's experiencing these emotions as you're experiencing them, and it's a really, really powerful thing to do. And so if you have different stories that you can tell about difficult things that have happened in your life, fun times, sad times, scary times, those are things that you can talk about and have fun with. And, you know, as long as it's not something that's like still debilitating to you in the current time, I'd only talk about things that really, especially if you're kind of new to the relationship and it's not a deeper relationship, you haven't been together for a long time, just talk about some things that you've kind of gotten over, or things that aren't a really big deal to you right now, so that it doesn't become this kind of weird dynamic where you're kind of pushing into kind of this realm of being super vulnerable in a way that he's not really sure how to deal with really early on. So another way to do this, and this is kind of a more passive way to do it, is to get involved with things that create emotions. So go do fun things, go do scary things, go do sad things, go to comedy shows, try doing something that's spontaneous, daring, risky, adventurous. And you can just do all kinds of different types of things, right? Go gambling one time if you guys aren't gambling and he doesn't have a problem with that. Or go try something. Go to an area you've never been to, a part of town you've never been to, and check out something you've never seen before. Just go do fun things. And the more kind of fun and interesting things and more things that have emotion tied to it, the more he'll start associating different kind of aspects of things to you.